Documentary photographs such as these have been used for decades to capture the truth about people's lives and the challenges they face. In the words of Elizabeth Brune, who was the longest-serving female art director of the Smithsonian Art Museum, art is not always about pretty things. It's about who we are, what happened to us, and how our lives are affected. In preparation for my talk today, this quote has been on the forefront of my mind. It serves as a reminder to me of what a good artist should do. Even though I myself am very involved in the arts, it's hard to forget, it's hard to remember why art is important in our daily lives because we live in a world of distractions. Today, it seems as though everyone is always chasing likes, comments, and views. With major social media platforms, society's focus on social media only becomes more intense. Now, we all probably know that we live in the digital media age, but even so, looking at the statistics is startling. Instagram itself has the amount of users almost equivalent to 3 times the total population of America. And research has shown that young adults and teens have been using an average amount of 5 hours a day on their phone. It's undeniable that technology is highly valued all over the world and is shaping the way that we live our lives. Even though my generation consumes the most visual media than ever before, this isn't necessarily beneficial. And with the amount of people joining these distracting forms of media, it's more important now than ever for artists to decide how to use our resources, not just to improve our art, but as a tool to make large impacts on our communities. Over the years, I've come to realize that art can and should be used as a form of self-expression, but art can also be used to tackle issues larger than oneself. If I myself want to be a good artist, I need to make work that not only reflects on the world around me, but changes it. Young artists all around the world have made the daunting decision to use their art as a catalyst for change. In fact, it seems now more than ever, technology has been used to support artists to spread their ideas on a global level. Personally, I was able to witness this from young artists and writers all across the nation at the Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. When I won a medal, I had the humbling experience of meeting the participants in the competition. For the first time in my life, I was able to meet other people my age who were as passionate, if not more, about art and also using their art for change. One of these artists I was able to meet was Amanda Gargat. Amanda is a hyper-realism painter who mainly paints portraits. Her phenomenal technical ability has made her a highly distinguished artist. Like myself, she has received a National Gold Medal from the Scholastic Art and Writing Awards. But not only that, she has been recognized as a national scholar in the arts from the Young Arts Organization. Using her portraits, she's able to physically show the faces of her own community and give an open platform to voices who may not be heard. Her phenomenal talent is an example of the potential of young artists today. On a more global level, art continues to act as a platform to discuss important issues in our society and change people's perspectives. For instance, one of the most nationally publicized works of art activism was the We the People campaign that was created by Shepherd Ferry in collaboration with Jessica Sabogal, Ernesto Urena, and Mark Gonzalez. I'm sure many of you here today are able to recognize these images, but for those who don't, I can give you a little more information about the project. In reaction to our polarizing political climate, these 3 artists decided to act rather than watch. They created these politically charged posters with the title of We the People, referring to the opening line of the US Constitution. In his own words, Shepherd Ferry has said that this project was about making sure that people realize that We the People means everyone, and that the posters act as a way to remind people to find their common humanity and look beyond maybe one narrow definition of what it means to be an American. Now, I could come here and talk for hours about the inspiring and powerful pieces of art that have been created, But the real message I'm here to share today is that art can and has been used as a way for people to raise awareness about the issues around them while uniting people and bringing them closer together. It's important that we encourage the youth of today to use their own artistic voices to not just focus on the pretty things around them. JFK once said that art is not propaganda, but a form of truth. What truth is inside you that needs to be made known? Thank you.